Amen. And let me just say this before we go into the word. When I talked about if you're an accountant and a lawyer, don't take it the other way around. If your profession is okay, and I'm talking about, when I'm talking lawyer, accountant, I'm talking about somebody just coming into the country. Now, if you're like, yeah, your profession is good, you don't need to go and do the IT certification anymore. I'm not addressing you. I'm talking about people that just want a change. You are tired of the paycheck and 4, 5 years, 3 years, the same score. That's what I'm talking about. Do you guys understand? And information is what changes men's life. You may not be aware. I thought everybody is aware in this capital region, even in this church. I think no people are not aware. Amen. But for me, I found out that they say, you can't go far with 30, 35 in this nation. All those paychecks. I'm telling you, I'm just being honest. You know, the truth cannot be, it must be told. So please, just avail yourself with this training. Even if you are in your profession, you can just additional one. Because when you get those jobs, you can work in your house. They just give you a laptop. That's it. That's your office right there. So there's nothing wrong with even with your profession now, having an additional income. And it shall be well in Jesus' name. Wave your hand and just bless the Almighty God. Father, we just thank you. Worship him. Give him glory. It's a hour to hear his word. Hallelujah. Father, today we ask that you breathe upon your word. And at the end of everything, we promise to give you the glory. And where you reign, no other power can reign. So Holy Spirit, reign in our midst. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
So I got to hurry up. Amen. Or wherever I stop, I'll stop there. Amen. Because of time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. We're talking about the supernatural increase. Supernatural increase. This is the prophetic word God has given us in this anniversary. But let's look at the definition of supernatural. What is supernatural? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Beyond what is normal. Unexplainable. Something that you cannot explain. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the supernatural is caused by the force that cannot be explained by science. Hallelujah. So God is bringing us into a thing that nobody will be able to explain.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Blessing beyond explanation. Increase to become greater.
Amen.
As in number or size or strength or quality to multiply. That is increase. So how many of you want to see increase? Increase.
Amen.
And now, because of this supernatural, God made me to know there's going to be open doors. You see, maybe, are you in church this morning?
Amen.
There's going to be open door. Now, I'm even hearing, it's not just for me, it's a wider door. Hallelujah. Now these are doors, you know, maybe you have experienced open door before, but this kind of door will be like the door you have never experienced.
Amen.
I thought somebody will say a better amen to that.
Amen.
Please don't limit God. This supernatural will cause men to marvel around us.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It will bring wonders. We will experience the wonder working power of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because how do you explain the increase of Isaac when other people are failing? That is beyond man. The woman of God said, the supernatural is the super of God coming upon the natural of men.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's a matter. When you do business with God, you can't remain small. And it was, she was talking about relationship. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But quickly, I want to go into this message this morning. Hallelujah. Now, somebody says supernatural.
Supernatural.
Now, put increase. Supernatural increase. Now, this word that God has brought to us this time is a prophetic word. Supernatural word, increase, is a what?
Prophetic
word. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, a prophetic word must become a vision to you.
Amen.
Now, listen, church. Now, God brought a word to us, flood of blessing. It's a prophetic word. But until this word becomes a vision to you, then you cannot run with it. Oh Lord, is everyone hearing me?
Amen.
Now, when you hear a prophetic word, it must become a vision. The word must become revealed. The word must become what? A revelation. When it becomes a revelation, your attitude towards the prophetic word will what? we change. Now quickly, let's go to Proverbs 29:18. Proverbs 29:18. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Many of us, this vision in 2020, flood of blessing, it was never clear to some people. Have you been to the doctor, eye doctor, they'll talk about the 2020 vision. That is a clear vision. But when your vision is not good, hallelujah, even to get a driver license, they'll put a restriction on it. Hallelujah. But when your vision is clear, no matter what comes your way, you shall can see it. Now, in this vision, flood of blessing, no matter the challenge that you face, even when you are not seeing any blessing, because you have a clear vision, you will not let anything distract you.
Amen.
God said to Abraham, if you can see it, nothing can stop you.
Amen.
But the question with many believers is that prophetic word goes forth, but we don't see it. That's why I want to read this to you. Say, when there's no clear prophetic vision, what happened? People quickly wander astray. Now, many people receive this word, but many walk astray. Hallelujah. Because the word did not become a word, a vision. But when you follow the revelation of the word, oh Lord, is somebody hearing? When you follow the revelation of the word, heaven's bliss fill your soul. So when the word of God becomes a revelation, hallelujah, joy enter into your life. Then you become a partaker of that prophetic blessing. But when there's no clear prophetic vision, people quickly wander away. Hallelujah. And that's why David says something in the book of Psalm 119, verse 10. Psalm 119, I tell Ross this thing. You gotta flow with me this morning. Psalm 119, verse 10. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Psalm 119, verse 10. You have it? I have longed for you with the passion of my heart. Don't let me stray from your direction. Now, the direction for us this year is what? Flood of blessing. But if it does not become a vision to you, you will stray from the direction. Are you getting this thing? That's why you could not see it. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2. Hallelujah. What's this now? God, let's go there. He said, write the vision. Hallelujah. Now, if a word comes into the church and you dare write it down and put it in your bathroom, it's different from someone that just hear it and just walk away from the church and just go and come back next Sunday. Oh no, you didn't get that. A person that hears the word of God in the church, write it by the bedside of his bed and on a wall and in the kitchen and in the bathroom, it's different from somebody that comes to church, hear it, and assume I already know it. Because that person that writes it down is no longer an ordinary word. Oh my God. Now that person is looking at it in the bathroom. Ah, in the name of Jesus, I must see flood of blessing.
Amen.
Oh my God, you don't understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Make it plain upon the tablet, that it may run that readeth it. So somebody that the word of God has become a vision is no longer walking with, he's running with it. I must see the flood of blessing.
Amen.
And there's a man ticket. He becomes it. Oh my God.
Amen.
So the problem with us, with many believers, is that we don't run with what? The vision. Now quickly, let's go to Jeremiah 33 verse 19. Amplify. Now God has brought us to another season now. Supernatural what? Now, in this anniversary, what do you think is in the mind of God? What do you think is in the mind of God? Increase is in the mind of what? Of God. Hallelujah. Do you see it? Do you believe it?
I believe it.
What's this now? Thank you, Jesus. Do you have your shouting clothes? Have you have your amen? You ready to say your amen? How many of you have a 2020 vision? And I'm not talking about 2020, I'm talking about this all terminologies and all that, you know, the science. So I'm like, is it clear to you that you are going to increase?
Yes.
Now, as I'm saying supernatural increase, something might be telling you and say, it's not for me. Me that I'm making how much? Oh, my father, there's nobody that is more rich in our family. Pastor is talking about increase. No, if there's nobody.
donkey that ever reaches, never reach your family, you will be the number one.
Amen.
By this blessing, you'll be what? Number one. Isaac, Abraham became number one because the blessing came upon him. The father never had money. The father died trying. The father tried. If I remember in this church, you will never hang when your father hang. You will never hang when your mother hang. Hallelujah. No, no, that will be an aberration. Hallelujah. That will be like God is no longer God. Hallelujah. Isaac was better than Abraham. Jacob was better. Hallelujah. So Jerusalem will be to me a name of joy. Now do me a favor. Do you see the vision? If you see the vision, you will not put Jerusalem. You will put land repeaters. Oh, I'm not going to come here on this side and preach it. Land repeaters will be to me a name of joy. A name of praise and glory before all nations. Before how many nations?
All nations.
All nations of the head. Now, don't limit God. When God say all nations, some of you now can feel your energy. You are thinking all nations. Let me just be blessing opening. No, that's not the man of God. The man of God is that all nations will hear from you. Now, maybe there's a Pharaoh that God has sent to me. In the name of Jesus, the all nations of this world will hear your blessing. Listen, church, whether you like it or not, if you are in Zimbabwe or Angola or in Spain, you must know about the owner of Facebook and your WhatsApp. You must know them. Hallelujah. Whether you like it or not, what are they doing about them? The blessing in their life is touching all nations. You don't need to leave America before people hear you. Oh my God, you don't understand what I'm saying. You don't need to leave here.
Amen.
God send me to somebody.
Amen.
You don't need to leave before they hear.
Amen.
Now, there's somebody, if you don't like it, I put a blessing on your children.
Amen.
You know that some people, you're already tired, you're already tired. Me, I'm not retired though. You are already retired, man. This one person is talking about. I'm okay. No, 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 no. If you're okay, I'll push you out of the way and let it land on your children in the name of Jesus. Because your children need it.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Do you think our children want to live in the kind of house we are living? If you don't have it, you call them and speak to them. You think you are blessed? Yeah, okay. You ask them if they want to live like you. You'll be shocked. Am I alone in the church? Have you had a conversation with your children before? You think they want to live your life? Let me stop preaching. Should I stop?
Yeah.
Jerusalem will be to me a name of joy. A praise. No, I missed that. Larry Peters will be to me a name of what? Of joy. Praise and glory before all nations of the earth. We shall hear of all the good that I will do for it.
Amen.
Are you ready? Do you have a vision for it? All the good, not sure, all the good.
Amen.
And they shall fear and tremble because of all the good and all the peace. Because of all the good, peace, security, stability that I will provide for it.
Amen.
I stand on this exalted altar. My God will provide for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, God told me last night, listen, church, I don't claim to be a prophet. But he told me I want you to operate in your office as a prophet. Every word I say today will come to pass.
Amen.
He told me last night. He told me, and I believe it.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I say my God will provide for you.
Amen.
Now listen now. All the good that I will, God is not a liar. If you will not do it, you will not put it in the Bible.
Amen.
And he said, it is written for you and I so that we can follow this example.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he said, all the peace. That means, what is the peace God is talking about? Someone, my peace I give unto you. The peace God is talking about, he's talking about prosperity. No money, no peace. Your God is aware of it. Oh my God, I'm not praying for somebody. God is aware of it that if you don't have money, you can't have peace.
Okay,
I'm
gonna stop.
You're
not responding to what I'm
saying. Hey. Oh my God. No money, no peace. Hey. If you agree with me, stand up. What are you talking about? Be seated. And if you're not careful now, the way you are, I'll keep you to 6 o'clock in the church. You are the door of the church. Hallelujah. All night service. tongue here. All day. Hallelujah. Jim, what's his name? He said, the peace God is talking about. I'm telling you, John. You know what? Increase is in the mind of God. What is in your mind? If your mind does not agree with him, you can't have it. In the beginning, he blessed them and said, multiply, increase. Increase. So that means, if you are a child of God, 1 year in the States, or 2 years, 3 years, you are against God. Your life is not speaking what he said. You are making him a liar. Every life in this church this morning, making God a liar. In the name of Jesus, I pray that the blessing of God come upon your life. He said, I will give you my peace. What is that peace? Prosperity, security, stability. If you don't have job security, you cannot see a place. There's no, if your job is part time, there's anxiety. God said, that's not what I want. Everyone on a part time job, that the job is not confirmed, on this authority of his word, I confirm your job. Come and say it. The heart of kings is in his hand. Your establishment, in that as this one goes forth, they will confirm you on that job. I thought you will have a better heaven. Because the peace of God. Hallelujah. Prosperity, you know, prosperity, security, and then stability. God will give you stability.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
If I'm not stable, how can you be happy? Hallelujah. Moving from one job to the other, no, that's not true. Good in that. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Moving one step to another, no. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said, hallelujah.
Amen.
Remember, God give you financial stability.
Amen.
I thought I would have a better. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Now, quickly, let's go to Samuel 15. Someone said, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
The increase is in the mind of God. Hallelujah. There will be open, new open doors in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Now, watch this now. This is very important. Let's just do this in Passion Translation because of time. Go to Passion Translation. Samuel 15 verse 12 to 15. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Amen.
What's this now? You have a medium? Samuel 15 verse. Alright. I want to know who we are. If you already have the vision now of supernatural, I will know. What's this now? What's this now? The Lord will never forget us in our need.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't see anybody with 2020 vision. I got my wife. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because as soon as that word hits you, you know that the Lord will never. If I finish preaching today, it's okay. You belong to God.
Amen.
You are His. Somebody say, I belong to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What's this now? The Lord will never underline your Bible.
Yes.
It will never. It will not leave your child in that mess.
Amen.
Can you understand? God is preaching to somebody. He will never forget us in our need.
Amen.
Do you have insurance? I'm about to speak my language. He said he will not leave you in your challenges. Oh my God. Is somebody alive in church? This is increase right here. Hallelujah. The blessing is here. The blessing is here. The Lord. Who is this Lord? Strong and mighty. The King of glory forever. The Almighty. The doer of all things. There's nothing impossible with him. When he said yes, nobody can say no. When you open the door, nobody can say no. When he decide to open it, he said, I should tell somebody to remind you, my name is Mighty.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
He said, I should tell you, he's Mighty.
Yes.
Stop looking at God, it's not a little God.
Yeah.
It's a big God.
Yeah.
Agbara no noru mi. Agbara. Agbara ipo. It means my God is so powerful. Powerful to deliver. Powerful to set free. Powerful to lift up. Powerful to change your story. Powerful to bless you. man got to a point in his life and said to God, I know you can do anything and everything, and nothing can upset your plan. Now, the plan of God, the last time I checked, he said, is good. There's no witch in your father's house that can change it. Every good that God has determined for you before the end of this year, there's no witch that can stop it. Somebody, I want you to stand up. Open your mouth. The good that God has for me at this end of the year, no devil can stop it. Open your mouth and say that. God is telling me there's somebody here, because of what I'm saying, because of your word that you're preaching to my people, I will not leave them in their need. He said you have escaped as a bird from the net. You have been captured before you are here. He said that's why there's no movement in your life. He said you have been captured. You know when they cage a bird, that's why there's boundary around you. You try to move, it's not moving. They have caged you. He said the cage is broken right now. He has broken every chain. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whoever the Lord set free. Oh, your daddy set that fellow free. Whoever the Lord set free is free indeed. There can never be shackles on your leg. There can never be shackles on your head. Remember, you said you have blessed your hand. Every chain on your hand. Every chain on your arm. Break! 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 Every chain on your leg. Daddy, if there was no need, you would not command deliverance for Jacob. You command the deliverance, sir. I stand on the authority of your name, and I command you, Lord, command deliverance here now. Somebody say, receive my deliverance. How can a man cage you? Somebody say, I refuse to be caged. I escaped today. He said, he will set you upon your high places. Whatever might be your challenge, I see you standing tall on it. Listen. Hallelujah. Amen. It's a new day. Just say it's a new day. The Lord will never forget us in our need. Amen. You can take it to bank any day. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. That's what the Bible now says. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you. In the book of Philippians, chapter 4. He said, whatsoever is a good report, that is the good report. Amen. If anything ever tell you to remain the same, you say no. It is written. The Lord will not leave you here. That's what he said. Hallelujah. Amen. The Lord will never forget us in our day. He will bless us indeed. Amen. Bless me indeed. The prayer of Jabez. There's a fellow here. Amen. My God will bless you indeed. Amen. Is he a lie? Amen. Is he a lie? He will bless you all, indeed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. Go back to Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You see, whatever is lovely, how can you be thinking that you remain on a bad job? You can't be thinking of seeing yourself in a better job. Go back to the above every day. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Holy Spirit. Jesus. He will bless us indeed. In other thoughts that we'll be having, amen. Amen. Amen is agreement to us. He will bless the house of Israel.
Amen.
This house is blessed.
Amen.
He will bless the house of Aaron.
Amen.
His priests. Hallelujah. Keep going.
Amen.
Your house is blessed.
Amen.
I said by this supernatural increase, your house is blessed.
Amen.
Yes. Someone say yes.
Yes.
Are you in love of God?
Yes,
he will bless me, Pastor.
Yes.
See, if you understand, the moment I say he will bless the house of Jacob, you're supposed to scream, yes, Pastor, he will bless me.
Amen.
Yes, he will bless his lovers.
Amen.
Who bow before him.
Amen.
No matter what they are.
Amen.
No matter who they are. Hallelujah. God will bless you.
Amen.
Keep going, keep going. God himself will fill you with more.
Amen.
Yeah, more. Listen now. If you're on a job you're enjoying now, that's good. But God said more. More. Someone say more.
More.
I like more. Someone say more.
More.
More, my children. Hallelujah. More, my wife. Someone say more.
More,
more this church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It's not a lie. It's the word of God. It's prophetic. That's why I need you to see it.
Amen.
whatever God says, He is able to bring it to pass. Yes. Bible says, whatever is not declared, His hand will perform.
Amen.
Who is the performer?
God.
He will make it happen.
Amen.
He will, God Himself will fill you with more blessing. Blessing upon what? Blessing.
Yes.
Will be heaped upon you.
Amen.
And your children.
Amen.
From the maker of who? Heaven and earth.
Amen.
The very God who made you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just say more and more.
More, more.
Now, if you go to King James Version, go to King James. Amen. Don't worry. I'm looking at the time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
What's this now? Let's go to King James Version now. The same scripture. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord has been mindful of us. If anybody ever tells you, you know, the devil sometimes come to us and say, God doesn't care about you. Look at your life. It's a lie. God loves you.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. Even when you are a sinner before He died, He already loves you. He loves you. Don't let the devil tell you. He loves you. God loves you. Don't say, God loves me.
God loves me.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
No, no. You say, for God so loved the world again. You are included in that world. And if He can give Jesus, what else will not give you? Don't let devil deceive you. He's going to be well. You know what I just heard right now? He's going to be alright.
Yeah.
There's nothing that I need that God will not supply if I believe.
Yeah.
My prayer for you is for you to just agree with God.
Yeah.
Let the word of God become your final authority.
Yeah.
Don't believe the devil. He's not the final authority.
Yeah.
If they didn't give you that job in your back, they are not the final authority. The final authority says you will get it better than that. Hallelujah. Alright, you did a course and you know you have D. Okay, hallelujah. The Bible says if you fall, you will rise.
Yes.
That's the final authority. So you tell yourself, I'm coming up at the next time I'm writing this course, I'm coming up with A.
Yes.
Don't let your challenge become the final authority. Who is the final authority? The word of God. And the word of God says, it's taught towards you and what? Good. Amen. I said,
amen.
Message, you will end up better than you are started.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He said to Job, though your beginning might be small,
yes,
but your latter end shall greatly increase.
Yeah.
It means you will end up this year better than you started.
Yeah.
Somebody shout.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
What's this now? The Lord has been mindful of us. He will bless us. He will bless the house of Israel.
Yes.
He will bless the house of Aaron. Yes. He will bless them that fear the Lord, both small and great. Yes.
Amen.
The Lord shall increase you.
Amen.
Increase is the mind of God.
Amen.
God want to increase me.
Amen.
Personalize it. God want to increase me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Increase you more and more.
Amen.
Someone say more and more.
More and more.
That means what you think that you have now, like he said, it's not. God is saying it's not okay.
Amen.
He want to give you more. Are you going to be like receptive to it?
Amen.
The one of us said to you yesterday, if you take 1 billion from God's account, it doesn't shake.
No.
Someone say no shaking.
No.
He's been blessing before they born you and me.
Amen.
Is he blessing? They call him, I'll give you interpretation. I go my bed. Okay, how can you be so insensitive to things and you go to the river and say you want to empty the river?
Yeah.
You take a bucket and say, I want to empty this river.
Yeah.
The river will empty you.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, because by the time you go by yourself,
yeah,
you go whatever. You go to Niagara Falls and say, I want to stop this water. How long will you be there? God has been blessing, He's still blessing.
Amen.
He bless you, cannot move you. You know, the woman of God said, he said, till now you have asked nothing. That means I want to bless you. Daughter, ask.
Amen.
Daughter, ask. I want to what?
Yes.
I want to bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said, hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Someone said, more and more.
More and more.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Increase is in the mind of who?
God.
Of God. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
I said, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Now, because of time, Holy Spirit, help me here. Genesis 26. This is very important. Hallelujah. A man called Isaac.
Maybe you are challenged now. Things are better. It's going to get better.
The man was a challenge. It was a time of famine. That means there was economic hardship in that time. So this man wanted to go to Egypt. Don't go to Egypt. There's no help in Egypt. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, stay here and I will bless you.
Amen.
I will be with you.
Amen.
You know why you can be stressed assured that you are going to be blessed? Because God is with you.
Yes.
And God cannot watch poverty.
Amen.
No. He cannot watch challenges forever.
Yes.
He said, I've seen the affliction of my people and I've come down to deliver them.
Amen.
He can't be with you and remain the same. You need to see that vision. You need to understand it. It has to be revealed to you. God, you can't be in my house and this need persist. No. 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 A man said to God, he said, God, I cannot die because when you said XYZ, I was saying, okay, it's true. He said, I cannot die. When the word of God become a vision to Nigeria, speaking to God, God is handicapped by his word.
Yes.
He must do it.
Amen.
He said, I've given him 15 more years.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, quickly, this man, Isaac, God said, stay here. Go to Genesis 26, verse 3. Let's read quickly because of time. I'll say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Say, louder, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Louder than you can. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Don't go to Egypt. God, help us on the way.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said, help us on the way. Don't go to Egypt.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Genesis 26, verse 3, AMPC. Or maybe Amplified. Let me see. What you got, media? What's this now? What? Okay. Dwell temporarily in this land, and I will be with you.
Amen.
He said, I will be with you.
Amen.
When God, he said, Moses, I'm going somewhere and I'm soon be rounding up. The land was a fallow ground. Famine. What's this now? That man has a problem. How the Holy Spirit help me here? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The land was not producing. Every other person in the land was failing. Hallelujah. Let me tell you something, your case is different. If others do not get it, you will get it.
Amen.
God, hallelujah.
Amen.
You can't go to America and fail. It's not going to happen.
Amen.
Your case is different.
Amen.
Watch this now. He said, the land was barren. But he said, God said to him, I will be with you.
Amen.
So, the factor here is God with you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If God be for you,
Amen.
Who can be against you?
No.
There's no situation. He must bow.
Yes.
And as I preach to you,
Amen.
The undiluted word of God,
Amen.
The word of Yahweh,
Amen.
Anything confronting you,
Amen.
Anything challenging the authority of his word in your life, shall bow.
Amen.
Amen. What is now? God prove.
Oh my God. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost.
Shalabakatalaya. Media, go to that Matthew. Matthew that I gave you. Is it 1929? Message. What's this now, church? So I said, God, help the pastor. I'm about, because of time, I'm trying to bring this thing home so that I don't take you to the Lord. God, the pages in that book, if I had to preach it, you're not going no more. Amen. So let us say, God, help the pastor now. Say, Lana, God, help him now. What's up? Okay. Say it again. Holy Spirit. Help him now. Give him speed. Say it out of God. Help my pastor now. Give him speed. I receive in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. What's his name? What's his name? God said he will be with him. What's I'm about to read now? Jesus looked at her, at them, and said, no chance at all if you think you can pull it up by yourself. There's somebody here, God just speaking, that's where he went. You cannot do it. You've been trying, you can't pull it off. You're trying to buy a house, trying to get a better job, boss man, whatever it is. He said, you cannot what? There's no chance at all if you think you can pull it off yourself. Every chance in this world, if you trust God to do it. So, what is your chances if God is with you? I read it again. Every chance in this world, if you trust God to do it for you.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God is now telling me, Isaac, if you trust me, where people are failing, I'll give you victory. Go back to Isaac now. Go back to chapter 26. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God will help you.
Amen.
You will pull it off.
Amen.
Before the end of this year.
Amen.
Your friends that are laughing at you. Oh my God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Just when they come to rejoice with you, don't give them a go-go roll. Because now you have messed up the blessing. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. And there was famine in the land. Number three. Say, I will be with you. I will favor you with blessings.
Amen.
I will be with you and favor you with what?
Blessings.
For you, for to you and to your descendant, I will give all this land and I will perform the whole which I swore to Abraham your father. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what God told him is that this family is, regardless of this family, I will bless you.
Amen.
Immediately the blessing came upon this man. What happened? There was a change.
Amen.
There was a change.
Amen.
And the man sold. Go to number 12 or 13 now. And the man sold in the same land, that same year. And God gave him what? And as he sold in that land and received in the same year 100 times as much as he had planted. And the Lord favored him. Him with what? The blessings. Hallelujah. And the man became great, increased. And gained more and more. Remember what I said to you? The Lord make you what? Increase you more and more. Somebody say more and more.
More and more.
More and more until you became very wealthy.
Amen.
And distinguished. The Bible now says, even as Isaac, you and I, we are children of promise. So if I go to heaven after many years and I'm not rich, I'm a disgrace to God. Write it down. If you go to heaven not being rich, you are a disgrace. Because he said to you and I, what did he say? Even as Isaac, you are children. He said the blessing of Abraham is for us, you and I. That the blessing of Abraham was not the blessing of shortage. The Bible said about Abraham, Genesis 24, everything that he needed, he got it. Everything that I need, that God will not supply, he will supply your need.
Amen.
I said, God will supply your need.
Amen.
So immediately the blessing came upon Isaac. What happened? The fallow ground was broken.
Amen.
So the blessing of God produces changes in the man's life.
Amen.
When the blessing of God comes upon your life, everything changed.
Amen.
Everything does what?
Change.
Abraham was stagnant. The God said to him, Genesis 12, I will bless you with abundant increase of favor.
Amen.
There's somebody here as you rise up, abundant increase of favor is coming upon your life.
Yeah.
When the blessing of God came upon him, what held his father down? Broke loose.
Amen.
Everything starts just changing.
Amen.
Rise on your feet. I'm about to, I don't want you to see that. I'm going to be tempted. But there's a scripture I want to give you. Why are you standing? I can't give you this scripture while I'm sitting now. I need you to be awake. I don't know what I'm doing. I can't give you the scripture while you are asleep. You are sitting down. You man, you know some people when they sit down, want to jump Sarah. You sit down, but when you're standing, you know, if you stand up and you're still sleeping, hey, what is that? If a man stand and sleep already, what is that? Hey, not in this church. Somebody say, I'm away, Pastor.
I'm away.
Shake yourself now.
I'm
away. Somebody say,
Amen.
Say louder,
amen.
Please don't sleep on this. Isaiah, you know, watch it now. Look at you and I. You get to a time when you have children and they're going up. You tell the senior or the junior one, say, look at your brother now. Let's say the child is not doing well or it's not making you happy. Look at your brother now. See how he's doing well. He's the same house now. How many of you know what I'm talking about?
It's true.
At the point they'll tell you, we will raise both of you now in the same house. How your home can't be different? Have you ever heard that before?
It's true.
No, I want to see your hand. Except you don't come from African home. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Amen.
In America, they say, oh, don't say that today. I'm going to say that. Don't let me feel bad. In Africa, they'll make you feel bad. Don't let me feel bad. Don't say that. You know, it's offensive. It's no. What? Of what? No, you tell the person you're not doing well. I can shake and do well. Say, oh, it's all right. You'll be okay.
Hey.
God have mercy, you know. See,
time, pardon me to say this, you need to be in America, but let Africa be your home.
Yes.
Let Africa be where? Be your home. Don't do like this. Yeah, but you're in America, but here, because if you want to take all this system here, the Lord have mercy on you. Isaiah 51 verse 2 message. I don't know the word. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah. Let's go there quickly. I want to start from verse 1. Yes. Listen to me. Are you listening? Listen to me, all you who are serious about right living and committed to seeking God. Ponder the rock from which you were what? God's cut. And the quarry from which you were dug. Yes, ponder Abraham your father. Now, number 2. And Sarah who bore thee. Think of it. One solitary man. This one going. What is solitary? What do you mean of solitary? No, what is solitary? Loneliness. Thank you, sir. Loneliness is going to be broken today. Singlehood is coming to an end. I've had him. Except you have not seen this vision now. You cannot remain single. No. No, you cannot remain under. No. Hallelujah. What is now? Think of him, one solitary man. When I called him, that's Abraham. Solitary. This man, nothing was happening to him. But once I blessed him, you didn't get it. Once I what? Bless him, he multiplied. So what does the solitary sister know? Me? No. What does a solitary man need? A brother looking for a better job. What does he need? Somebody that is sick with a challenge. What does he need? But once I bless him, he multiplied. He first started a solitary man. So he said, look at his life. He was solitary. But when the blessing of God come upon anything solitary, what happened? He multiplied. He carried what he was. He was changed. I don't know how many people need that blessing. I don't know whether who needs the blessing. But once I bless him, he multiplied. Likewise, I, God, we comfort Zion. Comfort all of them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Amen.
God wants to make the wilderness what? The water garden right now.
Amen.
Are you going to receive it?
I receive it.
Thank you, Jesus. Now watch this now. That scripture, and then we're going to pray. Go to Job 8:7. Job 8:7. We're going to go to message. Just message. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm going to pray. Watch this now. Please, hurry up, media. Please help me. What is the time now? 12:14. I said up until when? 12:35. What are you guys? Am I okay? We'll fight though, please. Why did I start preaching? I'm helping myself too. I just preach for 45 minutes. I mean, you guys, I have like 3 or 5 more minutes. Please. Please, please, please. Someone say please. Okay, Pastor, you're okay. Someone say, Pastor, you're okay. Holy Spirit, help me here. Hallelujah. Even though you are not much right now, you will end up better than never.
Amen.
And shouting growth, hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm gonna say it again, hallelujah. Amen. The Lord that your hand it will happen for you.
Amen.
Even though you are not much right now, your hand, you will end up better than ever.
Amen.
If you have a 2020 vision of this scripture and you put it by your bed, it will happen.
Amen.
It will happen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. A solitary man, he said, well, once I bless him, thank you, Holy Spirit. Now, everybody, do on your knee. Thank you, Jesus. Put your 2 hands on your head and say, God, you wrote this down for me, for admiration, for correction, and for my lifting. Media, you are going to be interceding, please. I know you have to pray too with that scripture that says, a solitary man. But once I bless him, Lord, you said I should look unto Abraham, a solitary man, nothing was working. But once your blessing came upon him, it doesn't matter the kind of challenge he was facing.
Once the blessing came, the life of this man changed. I need my life to change. I need my life to change. Oh Lord, bless me indeed. Bless me. Pour your blessing on me now. Pour your blessing on my children. Pour your blessing on my husband and my wife. My siblings, I don't want them to struggle. I cannot be the breadwinner alone in the house. I don't want my siblings to suffer, struggle. You see, it was so rich. All the single sister, brother, listen to me here. As God, the moment he says, so rich man. But once you bless him, the right partner came. Lord, by this blessing, I don't want to remain single no more. In the name of Jesus Christ, I come out of solitude today by your blessings. By your blessings. I come out of failure by your blessing. Oh Lord, you want me to do more and more. I'm already doing well, but because of this blessing, I exceedingly blessing, oh Lord. Somebody, you're praying. Father, I want to end better. I want to end better. I want to end better than I started this year, Lord. Though you are not much now. Father, I want to end up better than ever. Better than ever. God can do beyond my dream, beyond my expectation, beyond my hope. That's what you say you can do. Beyond my dream, beyond my hope, beyond my talk. Do it for me, Lord. Set to me, Lord. Bring me to increase. You bless them and multiply them. It's time for my increase. Like a blessing come upon your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hey, hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please rise. The woman of God sent a prayer to us. 4 a.m. this morning. 4 a.m. Someone say 4 a.m. You are not dead, though. You will be blessed.
Amen.
We need to put that prayer on the screen. We don't pray this prayer. And then we don't know. Hallelujah. See, in this time, you're going to be more serious with God. And pray, media, please. Please, media. How do we see this now? All right. I'll do it for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Someone say, oh Lord!
Oh Lord!
All right, good. Oh Lord, increase me with the increase of God!
You
are not sounding any better. Oh Lord, increase me!
With
the increase of God! Increase me more and more! Me and my children! Turn into prayer! The blessing is here! The blessing is here! The blessing is here! He was solitary. He changed it. Once I bless him, we are in that season. Once this blessing will come upon you, you can remain the same. Everything that you need, we want. Every locked door, we open. In the name of Jesus Christ. God, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Oh Lord, cause all grace to abound unto me, that I may have sufficiency in all things, and abound to every good work. Turn into prayer. Oh Lord, cause all grace to abound unto me, that I may have all sufficiency. Receive all sufficiency by the grace of God. All sufficiency. Receive it now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we are praying. Oh Lord, let it be louder. Oh Lord, anoint my resources with your increase, and let abundance be my reality. Turn it to prayer. Anoint, oh Lord, my resources with your increase, and let abundance be my reality. If God anoints your career, if God anoints you, underground. Maybe you're doing your master, you're a medical. If God anoints you, my God, increase the show. Shut up, all of the fire. Even in high school, let God anoint you. Shut up, all of the fire. Let them go to the fire. Lord, anoint this church, Lord, with your increase, and let abundance be our reality. In Jesus' name, we pray. Finally, he said to Abraham, he said, I will bless you like the sand of the sea. Can you count the sand of the sea? That means they could not count the money of Abraham. I will bless you. Look at the mind of God. I will bless you like the sand of the sea. Can you count the sand of the sea? Ah! Now they're going to pray. Hallelujah. Where's that one? Can you move it? Take me to your realm of beyond number. They can't count your money anymore. Pray that prayer right now. Take me to the realm of beyond numbers. Let me seek you. Take me to the realm of beyond numbers, O Lord. Take me, Lord, to the realm of beyond numbers, O Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we are praying. We cannot understand the last prayer. Say you move. Exodus 1:7. Pray Exodus 1:7. And then we close. Thank you. I'm sorry, but we cannot do these prayers. I'm sorry. Amen. What's this now? Exodus. And the children of Israel were fruitful and increased abundantly. Cause me to be fruitful. Cause me to be fruitful. And increase me abundantly. And multiply me. And make me to wax exceedingly mighty. And let me, you know, to fill this land means that let me have been part in this land. Hallelujah. My God, thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you this day. We worship you and give you all the glory. Thank you, Father, for answering prayer. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. And those that receive this vision today, we shall be loving. Hallelujah. If you receive it today, can you give God a shout offering? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's what we got for today. Amen. It's offering time. Hallelujah. The Bible talks about Isaac's soul. His soul. You cannot increase without giving. Your giving needs to increase. Proverbs 11:24. Let's go pray. The Bible says the liberal soul shall be made fat. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But let's look at it in Passion Translation. Message. I'm sorry. Let's put a scripture in message. It's offering. Let's put our tithe and offering. But I want you to see this. This verse. Amen. Proverbs 11. And we look at it, the message. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. What's this now? The wall around the generous get larger and larger. It's better to give. The wall of the generous gets what? Larger and larger. The word of the stingy gets smaller and smaller. He said, when I do my study and I see this thing, I fear. Hallelujah. The word of the stingy gets smaller and what? Smaller. Keep going. Hallelujah. The one who blesses others is abundantly blessed. Those who help others are helped. Can you just rise as we give this hour? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But look at TPT said, when you give, God will heap blessing upon your life.
Amen.
So he's more blessed to give. Let's give our tithe and our offering. Hallelujah. Let's sow unto the Almighty God. And when you sow, God said he will bless you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I said hallelujah.
Amen.
Listen, church, when he blessed them and multiplied them in Genesis 28, 29, he gave them seed for bread. So your seed, money is now your bread, is your meat. So when you release seed, what he has given to you, if a farmer will not plant, he won't eat. The way God structured this world is that you give seed time and harvest time. Rise on your feet as we give. Thank you, Jesus. Let's learn to sow like Isaac and a reap a hundredfold.
Amen.
What you give doesn't come back to you the same. It comes back in hundredfold.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise, O Lord. Blessing and honor we give unto you. Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise. Receive our praise, O Lord. Receive our praise.
of the leadership of this church, we want to wish every one of you as you go into this week a happy Thanksgiving. Hallelujah. And like I said, if you're going to need any talk, please let us know, and God will bless His people in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. And at the food pantry, you can also come on Tuesday to get some food. It's going to be here on Friday, on Tuesday, right? From 5 to like 5:45. Lord bless you all in Jesus' mighty name. Now, Lord, behold the offering of your people. Lord Almighty, according to your word, Lord, receive it, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And Lord, let the windows of heaven be open and pour us out a blessing. That will not have enough room to contain. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. We thank you for it. And we give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Master Jesus. Amen. For in Jesus' mighty name we are prayed.
Amen.
And the people of God say,
Amen.
Hallelujah. What's the vision?
Embrace.
What is the vision?
Embrace.
You write it down and you do what? You run with it. The run is in your face. Let's share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, His goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Let the blessing of the house shout hallelujah.